Dave Palumbo standing here with John Hansen. We are here at the 2014 IFBB Tampa Pro. The festivities are finally over. The finals are done. And we have a new champion, Victor Martinez, back from the near dead. And he's back on top in top form, John. How impressed were you?
Very impressed. This is the Victor of old, like we said. And he also had a great routine at night. He seemed like he was really having fun.
I think he knew he looked good.
Yeah, he knew he looked good. He knew that this was his comeback, and he really had a good time. I never seen him have that much fun on stage.
You know, I remember him having this much fun when he won the GNC Show of Strength a number of years back before he placed second at the Olympia. And you know what? He knows he has it back. Look, you know what? It's great to see Victor make that comeback, because a lot of guys at 40 years of age wouldn't be able to do that.
Yeah, exactly. And after all he's overcome, you know, just even the last couple of years of breaking his arm, going back to jail, you know, that was a really tough.
Sister dying.
Yeah, yeah.
He had
a million things
happen to him.
And she was murdered. She wasn't even just dying, Yeah, it's terrible.
You can't even make this stuff up. It's so crazy.
I know. So it's great to have him come back, yeah.
Victor is going to go into the Olympia now with a lot of momentum, with the knowing the idea that he's got his tools back in his tool chest, and I think that we're going to see a top six placing for Victor this year.
What do you think he needs to do to improve?
I think he can be a little tighter from behind, so I want to see the glutes and those feathered lower lats he usually has.
Yeah, I like the bigger, fuller look he has. You know, much better, obviously, than New York last year when he was coming back, you know. But if he can hold on to that and just get a little tighter, he's got enough time to do it. He can slowly get, you know, dialed in. I'd love to see that look.
William Bonick finishes second here, but not a disappointment for him, because he wins last week at the IFBB Golden State, qualifies for the Olympia.
Yeah.
He pushes Victor here. He's a close second. He's got to be very confident going into that Olympia. Here's a guy who people told, you're a 212 guy. You can't compete with the open guys. Now he's a champion. Now he's going to the Olympia.
Yeah, I was very impressed with him. Like I said, this is the first time I ever saw him, and guy's just got so much thickness and so much mass, and he carries it really well. And he's hard enough, and he can get a little harder. He's going to do really well.
He, you know, he has something that a lot of these other guys doesn't have. He's not afraid to be different.
Yeah.
And he said that, I don't care what people think. This is the way I'm going to look. I wanted to be an open guy. Now I'm an open guy. I'm a legitimate open guy. He's got the gold teeth in the front.
Yeah.
And, you know, he's cool. He's just like, he's like a Kai Greene in that sense.
Plus the hair. He's got the hair.
Yeah, with the crazy hair.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, and that's his trademark. That crab most muscular with the gold teeth is now his trademark, you know.
That most muscular is breathtaking. Let's talk about third place, Mo Benute, who has had some bad placings in the past. He seems to be moving up. He found the right formula. He's bringing tremendous conditioning in. He's maximizing a physique that probably structurally isn't a physique you'd see in the top three.
Right.
You know, you could tell that this is a hard work type of guy.
Yeah. Yeah, and he really used to make the top three unless it was a smaller show. So he's working his way up. Like I said earlier, I think he's really putting on some good size. And he can stand with these guys now. He's not just a smaller guy who gets by on just conditioning. He's still got the conditioning, but he's also bringing up his size a lot more.
You know, I always say it's frustrating for me to watch Mo Benute because I can relate to what he's going through.
Yeah.
When you're structurally challenged, it's impossible to beat guys like Bonick and Martinez. The best you can do is show up at your absolute best and hope and pray.
Somebody else is off, right?
I mean, that's really what it comes down to.
Right.
Finishing in the fourth spot tonight was who? Let me test your mettle here.
Max Charles.
Big Max. Max Charles, who arguably has the best upper body in the show.
Yeah.
Delts, pecs, arms,
abs too.
Small waist.
Yeah.
You know, he's got good quads. It seems like we talked about this earlier. His adductors and glutes need more size for him to stand balanced on stage. But to be an unbalanced guy and still make the top four here tonight tells you how good he is.
Yeah, absolutely. His upper body is really overpowering, especially standing relaxed, because he's so wide. He's got those huge delts, big chest, like you said, real deep abdominals. I think he had the best ab pose up there.
Right? Yeah. Best tapered.
Yeah, definitely. And like you said, just the legs. And the legs are pretty good from the front, but from the back, the hamstrings and calves really hurt him, you know, especially with that width.
It looks like he doesn't squat, but I know he does. But I think he just has to work a little harder on it. You know, maybe open his stance up or something like that, because I think he's got leg genetics.
Yeah, and maybe he didn't train him earlier in his upper body training.
That's what I think. Yeah,
that's what it looks like. Cause
he's playing catch up.
Yeah, exactly, right.
Let's talk about Ben White, the showstopper, who's back also in the top five.
Yeah.
Here's a guy who kind of disappeared for a number of years. We talked about him having a ton of potential back 8 years ago or so when I helped him, I think, win here in Tampa, actually.
He won the show,
kind of just never regained his form. He's back in form again. I'd like to see his legs a little bigger, but he stood very well next to these guys, especially in that front double bicep pose.
Yeah, his upper body was really big, shoulders and arms, but his lower body looked like it was more cut than his upper body. Yeah,
his girlfriend told me he doesn't like to squat. He doesn't like to train legs. He does all leg press. And you know what happens when you don't squat, John. You don't get big leg development.
Right. But he had the good separation. He had real good separation in his quads.
He's a freak in that sense.
It was almost like two different bodies in a sense, you know.
Right. Well, you know, Ben was a former power lifter, but he was never a leg guy. He was always a bench presser.
Right.
So you can see that in the upper body.
Yeah, exactly. But he was impressive.
Yeah, I think that, you know, we had a solid top five here tonight that would probably rival any of the other shows that we had this entire year. Going into the Olympia now, obviously, this is the last pro show, so we got our Olympia lineup. Now it's just who could beat Phil Heath.
Yeah, exactly. And what
do you think Victor Martinez matches up against Phil Heath?
I think he matches up very well because he's got a wider structure and he's got what I like to call, you know, a beautiful physique. You know, he's got really pretty lines. If he can just keep the stomach in tighter and come in a little sharper, we can get the Victor of old, man. He could really do some damage.
Absolutely. Now, Frank Roberson, the Texas Tornado, who is also out of action, wins the Best Poser Award here. Congratulations. I think he goes home with $500 cash. That's a great little I like when they do the best poses because it kind of throws extra monies at some of the guys that maybe didn't win something.
Yeah, and I never saw Frank, but I've always heard about him, and I was watching his routine because he looked like he had something in mind.
Yeah.
And then he started doing the Miley Cyrus thing, wasn't it?
Yeah. Twerked a little bit.
Twerked, yeah.
Now, let's talk about women's physique. This decision was very close.
Yeah.
After prejudging, I was thinking Karina Nascimento is going to win this. Tonight, I kind of changed my mind. I was looking more at Jillian Revelle maybe and Heather Grace. But it was so close, you really could have flipped a coin because all the girls had different type of physiques. Heather Grace wins. Here's a girl who started out on our forums as a winning best body contest. She went to figure. She became a figure pro. She switched to women's physique. Now she's going to the Olympia as an IFBB figure pro champion. What a great story.
Yeah, and she was definitely in shape. She was very, very hard. I think her and Karina were probably the hardest in the show. And she earned that victory because she was really in shape.
Not only did she switch from figure to women's physique, she learned how to pose online on Skype from Kenny Wallach, Skyping with her, because, you know, she didn't know the women's physique poses, so she's very new to this. And she looked like a seasoned pro out there.
Yeah, I couldn't tell that at all. She looked like she belonged up there for sure.
Now, Karina Nascimento settles for second place, which I know she's not thrilled with. She's definitely the hardest girl in the class, in the best shape.
Yeah.
Maybe not structurally as good as Grace and Revelle. We've seen Karina in the winner's circle before. What do you think hurt her here tonight?
You know, I really don't know, and I don't think she knows either, because I think she's been struggling with that. She's taken a couple third places this year, and she is in shape. And I think I could see her in the first place, you know, and she was really ripped today. And actually, it looked on prejudging like she was a little nervous, like a little uncertain.
I think she was tentative about posing her conditioning.
Yeah.
Like she had striated glutes, but yet she wasn't flexing them.
Right.
And I think she kind of left the door open in that sense. I think the judges want to see that conditioning.
Yeah, and it was almost like you said, she was holding back from talking.
But if you got it, show it.
You could see him, though. You could still see him because he was so ripped, you know.
So if you're going to show him, you might as well show him all the time.
Yeah, but I thought tonight she did much better. Her posing routine was really good. She did some Julio Gracias,
Salsa.
Yeah, and she did really good. And I don't know. I mean, she's got the physique to win. It's just, it's very close. Those top three were very, very close.
I think she'll probably do better at the Olympia than at a local show like this because she stacks up against some of the bigger girls.
Yeah, I think she should just keep doing what she's doing, come in condition, have that confidence up there, and I think she'll come, do really well.
Jillian Revelle, who recovered from heart surgery, she had a hole in her heart closed off in the offseason, made a tremendous comeback. She was second last week at the Golden State, and then she comes in here tonight, finishes third, which it could have, like I said, a coin flip could have said first for her.
Yeah.
She's got such good stage presence. I really think that, you know, when you look at her, your eyes get drawn.
Yeah, and she's got a very pleasing stage presence. Like she, you know, everybody likes her. And plus, coming back from that, what she came through, I mean, that's even more impressive than what Marvin Ward went through, you know?
Incredible, yeah. Let's talk about the figure division, which was one of my favorites tonight. especially since my Species Nutrition athlete, Latoria Watts, wins her first pro show in splendid fashion. She was fourth here in her debut last year, which a lot of people thought she should have won.
Yeah.
She comes in here, she really dominates this lineup. She's got such a great physique that a lot of people say, well, it's hard to compare you to other girls because you're so different. Yeah. But she's so different in the positive direction that I think that you have to make her win because she's so good.
Yeah. Yeah, her waist is so small, she's really freaky, you know, but in a good way. Like
it almost
you said.
Looks like it's not real.
Yeah, exactly. She looks like a cartoon, and then she's got the big thighs. So, yeah, I'm glad she finally got what she deserved. You know, I'm glad the judges are recognizing her.
And she works, she's a dealer, a blackjack dealer in Las Vegas, and she works super hard, I know, on her conditioning, on her diet, on her training. And you know what? I'm going to go on record. This is a future Miss Olympia here because this physique is will be rewarded down the road as people get more comfortable with it and she tightens up a little bit more.
Yeah.
I think she's going to be dangerous at that Olympia. I think she could be the dark horse.
She almost reminds me of like a Sergio Oliva of women's figure, you know, with that small waist. It was so freaky.
Absolutely.
People can't believe it's real, you know.
You know, I just, like I said, I think that if she tightens up a little of the Olympia, Nicole Wilkins and Candace Keene are going to be very, very scared when they see her step next to them.
Yeah, it's like a different type of physique. So if the judges accept that as the new standard, she could really
win for 10 years.
Yeah, exactly.
Without injuries.
Nobody can compare to her, you know.
India Paulino in the bikini division, back in the winner's circle. She ditched the yellow suit, her classic yellow suit, for a black suit. I like the new look. It was a little darker, but I thought it worked for her very well.
Not only the suit, but she had, it seemed like, a new attitude. You know, she was a little sassier, a little...
more evil, right?
Yeah, a little more edgy. Yeah, right. And it worked for her, right. She's got that dark hair, and it went well with the dark suit. And she never really smiled that much. She was, like, you know, more aggressive.
You know, she's never won the Olympia. She's won the Arnold Bikini International. I know that's probably the thing that she's gunning for right now. With the momentum she has, I think that she's got a good shot of giving these girls a run for their money come September, 6 weeks from now.
Yeah, I think she's on the right path, you know, because when you have the same look and it starts to wear down, your placings start to go down, you got to do something different, whether it's change your physique, change your suit, change your hair, change your attitude on stage. You got to do something different.
We saw some great physiques here, and I want to just say that, you know, I want to thank Tim Gardner and Dan Solomon for opening their doors up, letting us in, letting us cover the show. It was a great IFBB Tampa Pro. I'm looking forward to coming back next year. For now, though, I'm Dave Palumbo with John Hansen for RxMuscle.com.